We want everyone to be safe, and we're certainly going to be doing strict DWI enforcement to make sure that we get impaired drivers off the road and so that they won't be endangering the motoring public. We'll be doing stepped up DWI enforcement from probably around June the 28th. That'll run through July the 7th. And just to kind of give you an indication of where we are, at the end of May, there were over 80 fatalities that had been recorded here in Houston, and 26 of those fatalities have been linked to impaired drivers. So, significant amount. Want to cut that down. So we just want to warn the motoring public, don't drink and drive. We want you to have fun. So if you go into any 4th of July celebrations, have designated drivers, do other things besides drinking and driving. Two, it's a good day to get out and have family fun, but you don't celebrate the 4th of July with celebratory gunfire. We say this every year, but we can't say it enough. Really, there's no such thing as celebratory gunfire in the city of Houston. There's illegal, deadly conduct. You discharge a firearm in this city, that's deadly conduct. It's a Class A misdemeanor, and we're going to do everything that we can to try to put you in jail. Besides being, there's a reason why it's illegal and it's criminal conduct, because it's very dangerous. People firing, firearms into the air, those projectiles will come down, and certainly we know that people have been killed and injured. Sometimes the individual that's doing the, on the other end of the stupidity. So that's just a reminder. We got better things to do with our time and our resources to answer calls for service of some idiot firing, a firearm in the air for no reason, to endanger himself and others. Also, it's summer. Kids are out of school. The other activity that we want to caution parents and children is pool safety. We want people to enjoy water sports. But whether you have a private pool or your kids may frequent public pools, when you're enjoying water safety, although your children may know how to swim, do not allow your children to participate in water sports, swimming activities, if they're minors, without a responsible adult. And that's just a good policy, whether you're at home, whether you're at a public facility and lifeguards are on duty, you need to have someone that's responsible for your child. And if you have a private pool, you should have strict rules in place about how your children utilize your own pool while you're away from home, although they may know how to swim. Sometimes children play innocent games that sometimes be dangerous, whether they're playing in the water, holding each other underwater, and sometimes kids are not mature enough to understand and recognize the signs when people are in distress when they're in the water. So those are the three things that I wanted to remind the public during the summer that keeps everybody safe.